Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, now we are going to consider the numericals based on QM method. Let's start with the first example concerning QM method. Now, your problem is f of a, b, c, d equals to summation m 0, 1, 3, 7, 8, 9, 11, and 15. So, for the applying of QM method, you require first table is of, this is your table 1. We will write here mean terms and their binaries. Four variables you have to take, that are A, B, C, and D. Mean terms we will write here 0. Binary for 0 is 0, 0, 0, 0. Then we will take 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Then 3, 0, 0, 1, 1, 7, 0, 1, 1, 1. This is the binary for 7. Then we have 8, 1, 0, 0, 0. Then 9, 1, 0, 0, 1. After that we have 11. For 11 we can write here 1, 0, 1, 1. Then we have 15. That is 1, 1, 1, 1. In this way, you have to write the binaries for concerning mean terms. Now, after that, table 2 consists of group, mean terms, and their variables. Variables are A, B, C, and D. So if you see here, you have to search for group 0 having 0 number of 1s. So the mean terms are what? Only 0, and the value is 0, 0, 0, 0. Now group 1 having 1 number of 1s, we have 1 and then 8. So we will write here 1, binary is 0, 0, 0, 1. After that we have 8, that is 1, 0, 0, 0. Then we have to search for group 2 having 2 number of 1s. 2 number of 1s means 3. Mean term is 3 and 9. So we can write here 0, 0, 1, 1 and 1, 0, 0, 1. Now group 3 means you have to search the mean terms having 3 number of 1s. So 7, after that 11. For 7 we have 0, 1, 1, 1 and for 11 you have 1, 0, 1, 1. After that you have to search for 4 number of 1s. So 15. So you have 1, 1, 1, 1. In this way you have to write the table. After that, next table, table 3. You have to write group, then mean terms and variables. So you have to search for what? Group 1. Variables are A, B, C, D. So group 1 consists of 0 number of 1s. Now in this table, you have to compare these two terms, 0 to 1 and 0 with 8. So if you compare 0 with 1, so 0, 0, 0, this last bit is changing. So what you will write here? 0, 1, 0, 0, 0 dash. Means here only one bit should change and remaining term should be 0. So it is called as what? First group, 0, 1. After that we have 0, 8. So the term is dash 0, 0, 0. After that you have group having one number of ones. So we will check for 1 with 3, 0, 0, dash, 1, 1 with 3, what you will write here? 0, 0, dash, 1, 0, 0, dash, and 1. After that, you have 1 with 9, so dash, 0, 0, 1, 1 with 9, dash, 0, 0, and 1. You can check here. 1 with 9, dash, 0, 0, 1. Then 8 with 3, dash, 0, dash, dash, we can't take. Then 8 with 9, 1, 0, 0, dash, yes, we can take. 1, 0, 0, dash. Now consider second group. Compare 3 with 7. So we have 0, dash, 1, 1. Then next, compare 3 with 11. We have dash, 0, 1, 1. We have dash, 0, 1, 1. If you compare 3 with 11. After that, you can compare 9 with 7. So, dash, 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 not possible. 9 with 11, 1, 0, dash, 1. 1, 0, dash, 1. After that, you have third group. 7 with 15, if you compare, dash, 1, 1, 1. After that, you have 11 with 15, and your answer is 1 is same, it is changing 1 dash 1 1. In this way, you have to form table 3. After that, for table 4, you have to write group mean terms and variables. Variables are A, B, C, and D. So you have to search for zero number of ones. So what you will do? You will compare 0, 1 with 1, 3. Is there any possibility? 0, 0, dash 0 is not possible, so we can't take. 0, 1, 1, 9. Can we take 0, dash? We can't take. If you compare 0, 1, 8, 9, then what you will get? Dash, 0, 0, dash. So we will write here 0, 1, 8, 9 as dash, 0, 0, dash. We will compare 0, 8 with 1, 3. Dash, 0, not possible. 0, 8 with 1, 9. So, dash, dash, 0, 0, dash. Yes, it is possible. 0, 8 with 1, 9. Dash, 0, 0, dash. It is possible. After that, 0, 8 with 8, 9. Dash, 1, 0. Not possible. So, this is all about your first group. So, you have to compare now 1, 3 with 3, 7. So 0, 0, dash, not possible. 1, 3 with 3, 11. 0, dash, 0, 0, dash, 1, not possible. 1, 3 with 9, 11. So 0, 1 means dash. 0, dash, 1. Yes, it is possible. So 1, 3, 9, 11. 1, 3, 9, 11 is dash, 0, dash, 1. It is possible. After that, compare 1, 9 with 3, 7. Dash, dash, 0, 0, 0, dash, 1, 1. So, now compare 1, 9 with 3, 7. Dash, 0, not possible. 19311 dash is same. 0 dash 1. So yes, it is possible. 19311 dash 0 dash 1. If you see here 19 and 311, then dash 0, only one bit is changing. That's why dash 0 dash 1 is possible. After that, you have 19911. So 19 is dash 1, not possible. Then compare 89 with 37. 10 is changing, but 0 with dash is not possible. So don't consider it. After that, compare 89 with 311. If you see here, 1 dash again not possible. Then you have 89 with 911. So 89 term is 100 dash. You have to compare with 10. Again 0 dash comes, means not possible. So you have to go further. So second group you have to take. So we will take here 37 with 715. What you will get? 0 dash, not possible. 37 11 15. So one bit is changing, dash dash 1 1. So yes, we have 37 11 15 dash dash 1 1. After that you have 311 715 dash dash 1 1. Yes, it is possible. 311 715 dash dash 1 1. Yes, it is possible. Then 311 1115 dash 1, not possible. 911 715 dash 1, not possible. 911 1115 110 dash, not possible. So in this way you have to form this table 4. Further grouping is not possible. So next table we will see here. So we will form one table here. In this PI table means prime implicant table. It is a table in which mean terms has nothing a compressed form. Prime implicant, it is a term in which group of mean terms can't be combined with any other mean terms. So here if you consider the table number 4, so prime implicants are what? Here 00 term is present, so you can write here B bar C bar. Then if you consider the group 1, then these two terms are same. So we can write here B bar D. After that, if you consider group 2, then you have C and D. In this way, you have to calculate the prime implicants. Write down their decimals. Any one decimal you can write here. So we will write here 0189. After that, for B bar D, you have 13911. Then you have 3711 and 15. Now this is the table of the respective decimal. Now the table of mean term consists of what? 0 1 3 7 8 9 11 and 15. Now you have to make a crossover each term. So 0, it is present, 1 present, 8 and 9. After that, 1, 3, 9 and 11. After that you have 3, 7, 11 and 15. So in this way, you have to mark all the decimals. After that, you have to search for the unique terms. That is essential, prime, implicant. Now, how to search unique terms? Now, essential, prime, implicant should have only one cross below the respective mean term. So, if you see here all the three terms, only one cross is present below mean term 0. Here 2 cross, here 3, here only one cross is present. Below it only one cross, here 2 and here only one cross is present. So, you have to search for the line in which this cross are present. So, if you see here B bar, C bar has essential prime implicant terms and CD has essential prime implicant terms. So, finally your answer is B bar, C bar plus CD according to the QM method. QM method is also used to calculate the minimized form of the expressions. When K-map and Boolean algebra is not applicable to the given expressions, then QM method is the solution to solve the problem. So, this is all about the QM method procedure. In QM method, you have to calculate what table 1 consists of mean terms and their respective binaries. Then, in table 2, you have to form the groups in which number of logic 1 you have to calculate. Means group 0 means it is a group having 0 number of 1s and respective mean terms and their binaries. Again, group 1 means what? It is a group having only one number of 1s. So, respective mean term you have to write and their binaries. After that, again you have to minimize. You have to compare first group with second, second with third, and again you have to find out the group 0, group 1, group 2 and group 3. And in table 4 also, again you have to minimize, comparing group 1 with group 2. In this way, you have to calculate the final answer. You have to obtain the PI terms, means further minimization is not possible. After calculating PI terms, you have to search for essential prime implicant, means only one cross should be there below the mean terms, and you have to cross check how many crosses are there for respective prime implicant. According to this, you have to write down your final answer. This is all about the QM method. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and subscribe to Ekeeda.